evening, ladies and gentlemen. The Channel 4 Comedy Gala, an aide of Great Ormond Street, a lot of sex and drug references. A disgrace, if you ask me. For a kid's charity, did you take drugs? Big guy, white shot there. No, you don't. Good man. On TV. Wise man, wise. Don't want to hinder your future employment prospect. I don't take drugs. I get busted too young taking drugs. I get busted too young to fully embark on any notable drug abuse. I get caught smoking weed when I was younger. Do you know how I get caught, mate? Do you know how I get busted smoking weed? We were having fajitas one Sunday as a family and I rolled a fucking belter. And it aroused far too much suspicion. It became apparent that I had obtained these skills through illicit activity, as this was the first time we had ever sampled Mexican cuisine as a family. I let everybody else at the table go first. They're putting together these big, careless, lazy, reckless bastards, big monstrosities. Salsa hot rocks going down their T-shirt. I'm surveying the devastation, my own family, a disgrace to the art of rolling. Then I stepped up. I'm saying, pass me the skins, eh? The tortillas. No. I took three out of the packet. That's the drug users there laughing at that wee subtle gap. Are you having free fajitas, Kevin? No, Gran. I'm going to stick these together with some guacamole. Don't worry, Gran. You'll get a pass. And don't hog it. Don't get it wet at the end. It's disgusting. I get lost in my masterpiece, putting the grated cheese right across my setup there. Getting the chicken in, rolling it up nice and tight, asking my Gran to take off her crucifix. So I could make a bit of space at one of the ends there. Just about stopped myself before I ripped a bit of cardboard off the old El Paso box. What's your name, sir? White shirt guy. Matt. Have you got kids, Matt? One kid. How old's your kid?
Five.
Good man. Good. I don't have any kids. I think I'll be a good dad. I feel for the kids. It's a difficult age, isn't it, to be a child. I hear them going, Dad, this iPad isn't performing the new software update. Dad. Can we go to the Apple store and see the genius and have this resolved? Don't know if I could handle that, Matt. If I become a father, I think I'll be going, shut the fuck up, you wee tool. You're a child performing a software update. Go up to the loft, find a golf club, get in the bushes, fucking chop some nettles. No, get to know yourself. Go and get a big stick, you know. Just walk about, patrolling your neighbourhood with a big stick. Go and get a bit of dog shite on the end of your big stick. Patrol your neighbourhood armed. Sitting up in your bedroom getting cyber-bullied. Fucking go to his door with a bit of dog shite on a stick. I'm done with technology. Sending me bananas. I'm fed up, man. My laptop broke. I don't have a clue why it broke. Just stopped searching for wireless networks or some shite. I don't know. Just know the hassle that lies ahead. I'm going to have to take this into the Apple store to speak to fucking Mark with a C. With his purple genius T-shirt on, his big fucking beard picking bits of burrito at his beard. Really, yeah, hey. Big stupid earrings, the big hoop, or they don't have the earring in, the big ears left lying. Going to put your earrings back in, Mark, and stop putting people off calamari for life. And that's a risky business, Matt, handing your laptop in to a stranger. Your laptop knows you better than anybody knows you. Oh, had a look at your laptop, Mr. Bridges. We should have that back to you by the time you're out of jail, okay? I phoned up, that's what I've done. I phoned up the technical support line, far safer option. I'm sitting there, I'm furious. I get angry when technology malfunctions. I'm on the phone, fucking fuming. And nobody's getting any sympathy. People calling it a first world problem. You heard that before, Matt? First, oh, your laptop's not searching for wireless networks. First world problem.
makes me angrier. I fucking know it's a first world problem. That's why I'm on the phone to the third world trying to get it rectified. Right. That's on the phone. I'm on the phone in Indonesia talking to my man Derek. I'm explaining. And Derek knows his shit. He knows. He knows my laptop. He knows it well. He starts asking me questions I have never been asked before. He's asking for my IPVN phone number, my DHCP. I'm going, Derek, man, you need to back up here. Talk to me in human terms here. He tells me to go to system preferences. And he tells me to go to settings, network settings, and then advanced network setting. I'm in advanced. I'm in parts of my laptop I have never been before. He's guiding me through here. He starts asking if I can see my IPVN phone number. I said, yes, it's right there, Derek. He said, below that is your DHCP client ID. I'm saying, correct, Derek. He's asking if my DHCP client ID is configurated or deconfigurated. I said, well, it appears to be deconfigurated. Derek tells me to click on configurate. I'm getting excited here. Derek's onto something. Derek smells a rat here. I click on configurate. I go back and I try and connect to a wild fucking bang. We're back in, the laptop's back in the game. Then I'm left wondering though, who the fuck undone that? I have never been anywhere near this part of the laptop before. So what happened? Between the laptop searching for wireless networks and the laptop refusing to search for... Did I have an MIT frat party in the living room? Did I have Mark Zuckerberg over for a couple of beers one night? It's got a bit out of hand. I fell asleep, and rather than just shave off my eyebrows or draw a cock and balls on my face, this prankster has logged into my laptop and fucking deconfigurated my DHCP client ID.